We shot over 2 terabytes of footage and didn't back up a single card.
No hard drives anywhere to be found.
It's a very traditional process, and we're saying it doesn't need to be that way. It can be better.
We are on the set right now of our new product announcement for Fujifilm and RED. This is the first time that camera to cloud is directly in camera.
And we're shooting camera to cloud.
Camera to cloud's been around for about 2 years now. Initially, this required an external piece of hardware like a Teradexter 4K, which is still perfectly fine to use, and a lot of cameras will still require that.
But now, with the new announcement with the V-Raptor and V-Raptor XL, you're actually capturing 8K RAW and the ProRes proxy, and it's going right to Frame.io.
Previous to this, you could only send proxy files to the cloud. And then, as an editor, you would relink to the high-res files later. But now, I'm pulling down the R3D files right after I see them shoot.
Roll camera.
We wanted to show how incredible shooting 8K off-speed footage will work and have perfect parity with Frame.io. So that's where the snow comes into play.
And the idea was our new integration with Fujifilm and RED allows you to just shoot every take and publish it to the cloud with total confidence that that asset is going to be there.
So we aren't going to dump a single mag onto a hard drive.
We're checking those clips in Frame and then downloading those clips to a remote server and just doing an integrity check. And when we're done rolling, we're going to wipe the cards.
As a previous DIT of 15 years of doing constant downloading, that is just wild to me.
That's a cut.
It's about creative control. A lot of times the people in production have to go through these conduits to talk to the people in post-production, when it feels like maybe they should just be connected together.
We have our two editors on set. I'm on set. We've got our colorist on set.
Part of our job is to realize the director's vision as well. If I see that the director's vision isn't being realized in the edit, I can already start communicating that day one.
We now are giving editors the chance to jump right into an edit, connect directly to high-res footage, and be ready to rock and roll immediately.
I'm immediately able to work with Ray, our colorist, and start establishing looks. And we can start interacting with the full 8K files before it's even being edited.
Let's get ready to go again.
Typically, you have to trust your DP and hope they got it, or hope that it recorded to the mag, or hope that the mag got backed up, or that it got shipped. There's a lot of parts of the process that you have to trust. Camera to cloud is an opportunity for you to touch the footage immediately. It changes my attitude on set.
Cut there.
Frame.io servers are backed up multiple times over, so you don't have to worry about redundancy on set. You just have to get the files to Frame.io. We tested and proved that yesterday there was a small issue with our internet. We were still able to shoot and continue to shoot, and then once we got internet back, all the files just went to Frame.io.
Because you don't have to do as tedious work or redundant work, you are freeing up space in your mind, and because I have more mental bandwidth and have more time, the edit gets more attention, which means the end product is stronger.
And we're able to have rough cuts much sooner than any other production in the world.
You can get rid of your closet of hard drives and shuttle drives in RAIDs and move to the cloud.
I can't wait to see what type of content people are going to be able to create or where their energy is going to be able to be focused when you've eliminated all of this slow hard drive backup nonsense. It's really exciting to imagine what content creators are going to be able to do in the future because of this.
And let's cue the snow.